And welcome back to my YouTube channel. For this video, I'm going to be doing a testing video because you seem to like the last testing video that I did. So for this testing video, I'm going to be testing and reviewing this little collection. This was from B&M and it was £12. So you get this is the Soph X Revolution collection. So you get her three lipsticks and her Extra Spice palette. So yeah, this is the box that it came in. The palette here is like very reflective, so I'll just show you this box. This is the outer package that it came in, and then I've got the actual palette here, but like the front of it is like it's like a rose gold chrome, so it's like very reflective. Like, you can just see my setup. But yeah, this is the palette, and I'm gonna open it up quickly. It comes with a massive mirror, which is perfect. I'm trying to, like, because it's chrome, you're going to get fingerprints all over it, and I don't want to get fingerprints all over the mirror as well. But here is the palette. It's just upside down, so you haven't got the mirror in the way. But here it is. That's the palette, and then I've got the three lipsticks here. We have, this one is Cake. I really love the packaging of these. It's like a nude cream kind of colour on the bottom, and then a rose gold shape in the bullet. This is the shade Cake. And next we have this shade Syrup, which is super pretty as well. I will be like swatching all of these and showing you all of them. And then finally we have the shade Fudge. This one is like a dark chocolatey kind of brown. Yeah, so I'm just gonna be trying the eyeshadow palette, trying all the lipsticks for you, and letting you know what I think at the end of the video. So if you're interested in that, please just keep on watching. Before we start the video, make sure you go and subscribe down below. Like the video if you enjoyed these testing videos and you want me to try and test more things when I like get new products and everything. Turn on the grey bell so you're notified every time I upload a video. And follow my Instagram, will be up here and in the description box below. So I just put this pink headband onto my hair, out my face. I'm first going to start with a light layer of P. Louise base, because I'm not doing like a super colourful kind of look like I would normally do. I'm just going to do like a more natural kind of, maybe a pop of colour kind of look. I'm not going to apply the two or three layers that I would normally apply of the base, but like I've said in my previous videos, this is a must. You must like this product, is so good, you need it. So I'm only going to apply one layer of this. I'm just using my Acid Rain flat brush and I'm just patting this onto my eye. You've probably seen me like apply this before in like a previous video or on my Instagram. But if you're new, this is how you apply it. You just pat the base on. And like I said before, the more layers you add, the more full coverage the base is obviously going to be. But I'm just applying a thin layer and also carving out my brow with it, like the bottom part of my brow. So the base is on and I'm just gonna figure out what kind of colours I'm gonna be using. I need to use that silver, the shade Infinity. I need to use it, and I also really want to use the shade Cookie Dough, which is just like a light brown, this one here. So I'm just going to decide what I'm going to do and then I'll be back to do it, I guess. So first off, I'm going in the shade Brownies, this dark, dark brown here. And I'm using a Morphe M506 to apply this. And I just thought as well, like, my Jeffree Star mirror matches the whole client kind of like rose gold theme. But anyway, I'm just patting this into my outer corner. We're not blending yet, we're just patting it. Just patting in this shade. And I also just wanted to mention quickly, this whole like bundle was £12, but in normal like super drug stores or something, the palette I believe is normally £10 and the lipsticks individually are £3. So if you think about it, three lipsticks and a palette you'd normally get for like £19, but in the B&M store it was £12. So I was like, I've always like wanted the lipsticks, like as I've gone into like Superdrug, I've like, oh, they look really, really nice. But I've always just like given it a miss. But I saw this as like, when it comes to the palette and the three lipsticks, like before I would have only gotten one, But yeah, that's why I decided to get it in B&M. So yeah, we're just blending this, well, not blending yet, we're just patting this dark brown into our outer corner. And then now I'm going to go in with the shade Cheesecake, which I'll show you in a second. So Cheesecake is this one here. It's kind of like a, I'd say like red brown kind of colour. So I'm just going to apply this above and I'm just going to find a new brush to use. The brush I'm using at the minute is just an unnamed Morphe one. But I'm just taking, it's just a bigger fluffy blending brush. And on the eye, this looks very red, but that's okay. So far, these shadows are like really good quality. They're not like, the ones I've tried at the moment aren't really very chalky or anything. I swatched them the other day on my Instagram and they were really like creamy, and so were the lipsticks. The lipsticks was like so creamy, and I can't wait to actually wear them on my lips and not just swatched on my hand. But yeah, these shades are going on really well. I will have to go back in with brownies because we have lost it a little bit. But yeah, it's looking good so far. I'm going back in with brownies and just applying back over where we added it before, and I'm just bringing it in slightly further into the inner corner, not going all the way. And I'm going to just rub the edge to try and diffuse it a little bit. Going back in with Cheesecake and that big blending brush and just blending again. I think today we're going to be doing another half cut crease. You seem to really enjoy my cut crease video that I did a few days ago maybe. I'm not sure when this video is going to go up, but you seem to really like that video, and I've heard so many people say it helped them with their cut creases and stuff, which is really, really good to hear. So yeah, I'm trying to do more wearable kind of looks for you, so like they're not always crazy colourful cut creases for people that don't feel comfortable doing that. So yeah, now I'm going in with shade Cookie Dough, which is this one here, which is like one of the lightest brown shades in the palette. And I'm just taking another unnamed Morphe brush. It's a bigger fluffy brush. I thought I would mention this as well. There is a bit of kick up in the pan. I don't know if you can see that on Cookie Dough. There's a little bit of fallout on the pan, but that doesn't really bother me. And I don't really care if there is fallout like on my eye when it falls down on here, because I haven't got my base on yet, and that's why I decided to do my eyes first. So that any eyeshadow doesn't ruin any base that I've got on underneath. So fallout doesn't really bother me. I just thought I'd point it out to you just so you know. But yeah, it doesn't really bother me and it's not really a big deal. It's just how it performs on the eye. I know that Soph raves about the shade Cookie Dough and she absolutely loves it. So that's one of the I was really excited about this shade. But yeah, I'm also really excited for like the red, orange and yellow. I probably will do another look maybe on my Instagram using the brighter colours, and maybe do like a dark vampy kind of look. But I'm just doing a soft glam kind of look on here today. I'm going to go back in with my shades from the previous blends. I'm going back in with brownies and just packing this on a little bit more just to bring the colour back. Because we did lose some of it while we were blending. This is a really important step. No matter what kind of look you're doing, if it's just natural, you're doing like crazy cut creases, always go back in with your blends to brighten them up. I'll go back in into Cheesecake and just going above brownies and below Cookie Dough. All these names are like making me a bit hungry, like Cheesecake, brownies and Cookie Dough. They're all making me hungry. And I'm just here doing an eye look and all those shade names are making me hungry. Funny that all the three that I've used are food names. Finally going back in with Cookie Dough above all the other shades that we've applied. I'm loving these shades at the minute. They're applying so well. I don't know what it would be like if you just use concealer as your eyeshadow base, but because I'm using the P. Louise base and it is so full coverage even with one layer, I don't know how they'll perform with just concealer as a base or any other base that you use, because I know a lot of people sometimes just use their concealer, which is completely fine. But yeah, I don't know how it's going to perform without the P. Louise base. Maybe I should do a video doing like one side P. Louise base, one side just concealer, and seeing how good the P. Louise base actually is against normal concealer. I never used to use concealer as an eye base. I always used the Urban Decay Primer Potion, which was good, but like it wasn't like full coverage, you know, if you get what I mean. I don't know how to explain it, but it wasn't like, as you know, the P. Louise base is, I can't think of the word, oh my god. P. Louise base is opaque, whereas the Urban Decay Primer Potion is just like once you've rubbed it into your eye, it's all like translucent and you can't see it, and it's not that tacky where the P. Louise base is. Oh my god, got there in the end. Got this from Home Bargains, by the way. So I think I'm finished blending. I'm not gonna do my whole Vaseline trick with this because I might just go over with some P. Louise base, because I normally do the Vaseline trick when I'm doing really colourful cut creases and I don't want the P. Louise base to turn blue or pink or something, the colour of the eyeshadow that I'm using. I did it in my cut crease video just to show you the gist of it and how it works, but you don't have to do it with like softer cut creases. I just chose to do it in that video just to show you how to do it, and so you can actually wear that kind of cut crease and not just a rainbow one. Going in with like a small little dot of P. Louise base on my Acid Rain flat brush, I'm just gonna do a half cut crease. I'm cutting my crease. I'm going slightly higher than my natural crease, but not as high as I would normally go when I'm doing like a proper dramatic eye look. Another tip, if you want to do like your normal natural cut crease, is apply a little bit of concealer or base towards your lash line, look up, and then it will print a line for where your natural crease is, and then you just stamp around that to get the perfect cut crease to your natural crease and it not be really high up like I like to do. I'm just going in with a little bit of the shade Brownies, tapping off most of it and just stamping the edge so it's more natural and faded. Now I'm just going to go into the shade Infinity, which is this bright silver, and I'm just using this on a Morphe M166. This is just a flat brush, and I'm just getting some. This shade reminds me of the, I know, like Big Dupe. If this works the same as this, I'll have to let you know. But the MAC Shiny Pretty Thing shadow in shade Just Chilling. I've literally just tapped into this shadow. The MAC one is absolutely stunning. It is not available anymore. So if this works the same, then it will be a really good dupe because that shadow is literally stunning. Okay. I'm just applying this on my lid. This is working really, really well. Oh my god. I think this might be a bit of a dupe for the MAC shadow. Look at that. Oh my god. That is so pretty. Yeah, that's definitely a dupe for the MAC. I'll do like a side-by-side swatch on my hand. This is them on the fingers. This one is the Revolution one and this one is the MAC one. On the fingers, I can see that the MAC one is a lot more glittery, which is this one, sorry, than the Revolution one. But we'll see how they swatched. This is on like my bare hand. There's no base or anything down. So I'm just going to swatch the Revolution one. Ooh, that's pretty good. And then we're going to swatch the MAC one. Again, pretty good. So the top one is the Revolution one, the bottom one is the Mac one. I am pleasantly surprised. That Mac Shadow, I haven't been able to like find anything because I love using it, but like it's no longer available. But we just found a dupe for this Mac Single Shadow, so that is really exciting to know. For my inner corners, I'm going in with this shade Every Day. This is kind of like a, I don't really know how to explain the shade. It's a shimmer kind of, it's got a purple kind of undertone to it, and I'm just going to apply this in my inner corner. Yeah, it's got like a purpley kind of mauve undertone. Is that how you say it? I don't really know. But it is really pretty. So yeah, I'm really impressed with these shades so far. But I am going to go off camera and do the other eye and my base. And I'll be back to test the lipsticks. Right, so I'm back and I've done my other eye and my base. And I'm ready to test these lipsticks. When I swatched them the other day, my favourite two were Cake and Syrup. So I'm just going to swatch them and then I'm going to try them on lightest to darkest and then see which one I prefer and which will go with this look, and then I'll wear that one for the final finished look. So I've just swatched them on my arm. First, the lightest kind of pinky tone is Cake, the middle is Syrup, and then the bottom one is Fudge. These are so beautiful. I'm definitely going to get a lot of wear out of them. But first, I'm going to swatch Cake on my lips and then we'll go from there. So this is Cake swatched on the lips. First thing I noticed when I was applying it, it is super creamy. I love the formula of these. It went on really, really well. The colour is beautiful. It's definitely my kind of pinky nude kind of colour. So yeah, I really, really like this shade. So now that it's off, I'm going to be swatching the shade, Syrup, which is a super beautiful kind of light brown nude kind of colour. So I'm just going to swatch this and then I'll be back. So this is the shade Syrup, again, super, super creamy. I absolutely love this shade and I think this goes with the look really, really well. Here is Syrup. It is beautiful. Love it. Finally, we have the shade Fudge. This is like a really dark brown. Like, this is kind of out of my comfort zone of lipsticks that I normally wear. I normally wear like pinky nudes, a bit like Cake, or I don't really wear reds out, but I wear reds for like looks that like would need a red. But my go-to shade is like a pinky nude kind of colour. So I'm kind of excited to have this dark brown, like if a look needs the dark brown. But yeah, I'm just going to go and put this on now. This is the shade Fudge. Like I said, this is out of my comfort zone, but I actually really like the shade. Like, this goes so well with the look as well. Yeah, these lipsticks are so good. So creamy, love the formula. They're really easy to apply. The packaging is really good, which is a plus. But yeah, I'm just going to keep Fudge on just to like, it might grow on me a bit. But all of these lipstick shades are absolutely beautiful. And now I'm just going to go through my final thoughts and then the outro. So now we have the three bullet lipsticks. This is the, I was most excited for the lipsticks, if I'm honest. I love the formula, love the colours of them. They're like my kind of colours. Yeah, I would definitely recommend them. I can't really pick my favourite. Like, Fudge surprised me. I thought I would, like, love it, but, like, not as much as Cake and Syrup. But I do love all three of them, and I definitely recommend all three of them. They're £3 individually. So, starting with the palette, I, first off, love the packaging. I love the... Oh, sorry, if you just saw my whole setup and everything. I love the packaging. I love the colour story. I love the pop of colours, like the red and the yellow. The actual shades and pigments in themselves, they performed really, really, really well on the eyes, especially over the P. Louise base. I will have to try it with just concealer or just a different eyeshadow base. I have like the Urban Decay one, like I said earlier, but they perform really, really well. There wasn't much fallout on the eyes. There was a little bit of fallout in the pan, but like I said, that doesn't bother me. Overall, I think this palette is definitely worth it. I think this is her second palette with Revolution. She had brought out first one a few years ago, and she brought this one out fairly recently, like not really recently. But I love the palette, love the packaging, love the whole vibe of the rose gold. And the shadows perform really well. I like the look that I came out with. So I would definitely recommend the palette. I think it's £10 on its own. So yeah, I'd give that out of 10, probably like 8 or 9. So this bundle of the palette and the lipsticks, it is limited edition. I don't know if you can see it out there. Yeah, this bundle is limited edition. So I would get out to your nearest B&M store and try and find it. It wasn't with the actual makeup as it is. It was like in a separate aisle. I can't actually remember whereabouts it was, but it wasn't where the normal makeup is. But yeah, I definitely recommend the palette and the lipsticks. I'd give the lipsticks a 10 out of 10 because they're like my favourite. Yeah, but I don't know which one I prefer. But anyway, yeah, definitely recommend both these products. I really hope you enjoyed the reviewing process. I'm just going to do some close-ups of the look and everything, and then I'll do the outro. So that is it for this video. If you're wondering, my lashes are I believe the Mulan lashes from Primark. Don't know if they're still available, but yeah, they're the Mulan lashes from Primark. They're like £2 and they're really, really pretty. They like flare out at the end. But yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you subscribe down below, turn on the grey bell so you're notified, like the video if you liked me testing these products, and if you have any of the products and if you love them, give it a thumbs up. Let me know if you want any more testing videos, because they are really fun to film. Or like first impressions, whatever you want to call it. And yeah, and go follow my Instagram. It'll be up here and in the description box down below. Make sure you go and follow that. And I'll see you in the next video.